Zenic Order is actually a very good card. It's kind of like a tri-land. You don't know which one. It's a random tri-land, but in a deck like this that is playing at least three or four of the colors, if not all five, it's not usually going to miss, especially since your opponent's usually going to be three or more colors. Cordamuncus is actually going to be, I think, reasonable in this deck, even though there's no way I'm taking it here, because it wheels most of the time. Mana Force Mace is okay, but kind of slow. I think I'm actually going to take Armillary Sphere here. It's just a good way to make sure I hit all my land drops, and Sanctum Gargoyling it back isn't the actual worst with three resounding spells, so. Alright. This is pack is not great, but Fairy Mechanist works pretty well. It's a lot of four drops, but they're all two for ones, so you know, I can live with it. I mean, Absorb this is okay, but I don't even know how much black I'm going to be playing, so a black Land Cycler isn't really what I want. Sidraxis Alchemist, he's one of the guys I'm looking for. Right now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 blue permanents, plus Sharding Sphinx and Steelclad Serpent, but that's a start. I don't really need another Armillary Sphere, and Darklit Gargoyle, if I do want it, will probably wheel. This pack's a little unfortunate. There's not a whole lot here I really want, but Retro Banquet's actually decent. It's just a solid removal spell, especially in a deck like this that doesn't have a whole lot of guys, so you're likely to have their pick of at least the first couple guys they play. Hopefully get some Parasitic Strixes. That would not be too bad. Ooh. Ruptor Spire is good fixing, but pretty sure we're not going to pass up Esper Cormorants here. Again, it looks like we're overloading on our 4-drops, but we've got good removal spells to keep us until then, and we really want artifacts that powers our Sanctum Gargoyle, our Fairy Mechanist, our Sharding Sphinx. It all gets better once the more artifacts we have. So that's, you know, why I'm taking Cormorants over Avid Trailblazer, which is just kind of a little dork. And it's a good one, but... Aw, oh, man. Why does Parasitic Strix have to be in a pack with Esperzoa? And Esperzoa is ridiculous in this deck with 4 Sanctum Gargoyles and a Mechanist. So, clearly take that. I guess the Strix doesn't even have that many black permanents to key off of anyway. Esperzoa, that is. It's pretty late, Esperzoa, too, 6 pick, but I guess considering 2 Sanctum Gargoyles wheeled, it shouldn't be too surprising. It means that these next 2 packs, which I haven't seen yet, are not too unlikely to contain, you know, some pretty good cards for me. Or, you know, actually nothing, but that's okay. So not playing any of these cards, but would I be tempted to sideboard any of them? Not really. Like, the Balmgiver's okay. It's better in an Exalted deck that just gets in there. Here, I'm not really needing to give any of my guys unblockability. Goblin Outlander's okay against me, but card's kind of shiny and rare, so go ahead and yell at me if you want, but I don't mind. So here we actually have an interesting pick. Zombie Outlander is a pretty good early blocker, turns on Sidraxis Alchemist, and Voice from the Void is a pretty excellent discard spell. Voice from the Void has been pretty good for me in one of the last drafts I did with Cruel Ultimatum. Every time I cast Voices, it pretty much just got my opponent. On the other hand, I think I'm leaning towards a lot of expensive cards in this deck, so I'm going to go with the early drop. The card Homunculus Wield is I kind of expected. I think it's probably better than Brackwater Elemental here. Bunch of junk. Yeah. Mana Cyclics. The Darklit Gargoyle also Wield. It's pretty late Beacon Behemoth. I haven't run into anyone playing Salvage Slasher yet, but I'm sure someone has tried. Lapse. Lapse is okay in an aggro deck. It's not too great in a control deck like this one. I'm going to have a lot of cards for this deck, because even hiding some of the ones we know we're not going to play, we're still at, what, 28 cards here? We've got to cut, like, 5 of them. We'll take a look in a second once deck building starts. Alright, so cards I definitely want to play. I do include Wretched Banquet in that number, just because I think it's going to work out pretty well in the deck. Not inclined to play Steelclad or Protomatter Powder right away, but they might get in there. I also am not going to directly put in Necrogenesis, since it is off-color. I think the Resounding Thunder is going to fit pretty well, though. I've got Crumbling Necropolis and Armillary Sphere, so... Alright, so that's 22. Our options are the Necrogenesis, which I don't think I want, although a green source wouldn't be too bad. It might be worth actually just playing the Obelisk of Jund. It's another red source for Resounding Thunder. It gives us a green source to cycle Thunder or Resounding Silence. It's that or like a Rockcaster Platoon, but I don't see the Platoon being so great. Let's look at my converted mana cost. So we've got that. Plus the Obelisk does help us cycle one of our Resounding spells and gives us another thing to hit with Fairy Mechanist. Yeah, so I think I'm fine with the Obelisk. So, Mana Fixing is pretty good in this deck. I wouldn't mind having a green fixer, but let's see what Gobmodo says. One mountain, that's definitely correct. No forests. Let's see, four swamps leaves us 7, 8, 9 black sources, that's plenty. 5 islands leaves us also 9, and 4 plains. I think we want another plains and probably one less swamp, since their swamps are definitely not as important. Oh, we're good. Alright. Well, I'll see you guys in the next video when I start on my draft rounds.